Hey guys, this is Frank. I've been off camping for 5 days. That's one of the reasons why I haven't done any videos, because like the week before, it was chaos trying to get everything together. But now I'm back. We got home last night and we're all unpacked. On our trip, I took my portable power pack and I finished two of the battery packs that are in there, and it worked great for 4 of the 5 days. On the 5th day, we had some issues, and we're going to talk about those today. Hey guys, this is Frank and this is the DIY Engineer channel. And on this channel, we discuss things DIY. And currently we've been doing a lot of battery stuff, and I want to continue that as we talk about battery storage and also a little bit of solar power and a little bit of construction. So stay tuned. All right, guys, this is the inside of the portable power pack where I'm having some issues. I've disconnected some of these cords here. This is the first cell pack that I put together, and this was the one I rushed just so I could take on this camping trip. So I have the two of them. This one here does not have a BMS. This one does, and I still need to get the BMS installed on this, and then I have my other battery pack over here that still needs to be completely soldered together and a BMS put on there. So in looking in here, the issue I ran into was it started getting hot. The day was warm and my fans had kicked on. It was doing exactly what I had designed it to do, but then it quit and I couldn't figure out why. I would come to the front here and I would, you know, turn this button on and it wouldn't come on, and I just was having all kinds of issues with that. And so I started thinking about it, and this front switch here out the front, and it runs to these cables. If you can really see it, I'll get down here as close as I can. Under here, these cables here connect into this solenoid switch. And this is a high-end solenoid switch. It's 12 volts at 200 amps, so it can handle a lot of amperage. And that's what I wanted it to do, so that it could handle the battery juice that was being fed through there into the inverter, so that the inverter could actually function correctly. So I needed a switch that could handle that much load. Well, the thing I didn't think about when I was upgrading this power pack, initially it was only 12 volts, and 12 volts was my top end. Now it kind of maxes out close to 16, and I'm gonna be running it 15.5. So that switch handles 12 volts at 200 amps. And my battery pack now is at 16 volts and not 12. It's a lot of voltage. It's a lot higher. The switch, the solenoid switch, worked well for 4 days. Didn't have any issues. But when it got hot, when the kit got hot and everything started malfunctioning, that switch just did not like running at those temperatures and with that much juice running through it. And so now, every now and then it'll kick on and kick off, but I've actually narrowed it down to the fact that it is that switch, and I need to get a new one, and then I need to figure out a way to actually reduce the amount of power that I'm running to it. And I think what I'll do is in this lead here, I think one of these, I think this power here comes off and it comes back into here to provide power for this switch, and then there's a ground and another switch in here that runs the juice back over to turn this switch on, the solenoid switch, on and off. And what I need to do is just probably either replace this switch, or I might do a step down where I use a step down controller to go in and drop the voltage from anything that's over 12 volts, you know, down to 12 volts, so I keep a constant. And I think that's what I may try to do before actually buying another one of those relays. If need be, I'll just get another relay and replace it. But that's one of the things that gave me grief this weekend, was I had a relay that was underutilized. I overpowered it, ran too much through it, and it did not like it. So I found this solution. I was looking at a step down like this, but it was kind of big and bulky and a little more spendy. These are like $12 to $15, and I needed something a little less inexpensive. And I remembered I had these. They are just a little step down. They're tiny. I have not been a big fan of them because they're hard to adjust. And if you mess with them too much, like I did with this one, they just quit working altogether. So this one here just doesn't like it. But this other one, I'm actually, this one here I wired up, and I've got it to go to 12 volts, and I was running it off of a 14-volt input, so we should be good there. These cost on Amazon, they're $9 for a pack of six. So that's you know, less than $2 a piece. So that there is, in my mind, a good solution for, I will put this in and see if the power pack comes back to life, but if not, I'll probably end up getting another relay switch and seeing if that fixes it. All right, so I'm gonna go do the install now. Okay, after some work, I finally got the step down, voltage step down in place, and I got it set to a good voltage, but it's just, I can hear it making noise when I try to turn it on, and it just doesn't, it's just not right. It's not coming on. So I think I need to order in a new switch and go from there, and then we'll do a follow-up after I get it replaced. All right, so hopefully this was helpful. Just don't make the mistake like I did and put in, you know, 16 volts worth of batteries, you know, and then try to step it down to a 12-volt solenoid. It just doesn't work. So anyways,